can't tell if I'm excited or terrified again. Like, I got so smashed by GT Sophie last time, so to race against her again is a bit scary, but I don't know, it's fun. I always enjoy racing against a superhuman AI.
It's really aggressive, like, tends to attack you on the limit. That motivates you to push. It's a really good reference for make yourself even faster when you don't know how much faster you can be.
GT Sophie is a AI racing agent that can combine speed, skill, and racing etiquette to be able to compete with the best racers at GT.
そうですね、やっぱりまたソフィーとレースをしたいと思います。やっぱりその自分がこう知らない速く走れる技術っていうのをソフィーは持っているので、もっと技術を盗んでいきたいですし、まあ、そしてそのさらにソフィーとのレース争いっていうのをもっとこう楽しめるようなあのレースっていうのをしていきたいなと思います。
In certain situation I think it's possible to stay one step ahead, but in terms of pure speed, Sophie is, I don't know, already two or three steps ahead of us.It's always a learning experience for us, but what's also cool is that these players and racers are really good at what they do, and it's nice to see them push our car to its limits.
Sophie's biggest strength is like being precise. It's just perfect every time. As a human, I can't do that.
If somebody drives against Sophie long enough, they're able to see some gaps, they can exploit that behavior, and GT Sophie will not know how to respond. So I think it'll take a very skilled racer,And I think we are giving them the opportunity. The more they race against Sophie, they can find those gaps and they can then take advantage.
If I should really say something to Sophie, I will beat you.
Let's see what happens then. Here we are at the Sardinia Windmill Circuit. Race Together 2022 about to get underway. It is the GT Sophie AI versus some of the world's best Gran Turismo 7 competitors as Valerio Gallo leads the field to the timing line. Race Together 2022 is underway and Gallo comes over into the first corner with the lead. But how long is he going to hold on to it? Because I wonder whether Sophie Rouge in second place is going to attack. You can see the AI there using all of the circuits to try and maximize as much possible speed as they can going through. Sophie Blur there getting involved in the action. Looks like Yamanaka was coming under a bit of pressure from Sophie Ver as well. Here comes Yamanaka up the inside of Sophie Blur and going through. So the Samurai is through into fourth position then. So the AI losing out momentarily as Blur immediately gets it back through once again into P4.
Yeah, a lot of dust. Looks like Emily Jones moved up as well. Looks like Rouge has just taken the lead away from Valerio Gallo. So Sophie AI already up into first, making quick work of the 2021 Nations Cup champion. Igor Fraga, the 2018 champ, now hot on the heels of Valerio Gallo. All sideways over the jumps here as we go to Sophie Blur just behind Tomioki Yamanaka. Yamanaka practicing against the AI earlier on, had a hell of a fight with the Sophie AI. So I'm really interested to see how he does here. On board now with Violette as we are behind Emily Jones, looking for ways by. You see the different lines and approaches here. Look at the inputs on the right-hand side of your screen as well. You can see exactly what the AI is doing at every point on this circuit. And it's just fascinating to see them discover the fastest way around this circuit.
Yeah, you'll notice the AI don't counter-steer that much compared to the real-world drivers. So, as you say, very interesting difference in driving style. So already at the start of lap two, and look at how concertina the field up is up, rather, I should say. Oh. Look at that as Emily Jones getting really sideways there, losing one position, losing two as Violette comes through and into fifth place. Yamanaka also getting ahead. So those two now going toe-to-toe with one another. It's Yamanaka versus Violette. Fraga, meanwhile, just got the better of Valerio Gallo. Gallo looks like he's made a mistake. The Italian down to P3. So it's three drivers running nose-to-tail, bumper to spoiler as Violette sends it up the inside of Tomoaki Yamanaka and goes through and is now going to pick the pocket here of Gallo as well. So this is really exciting stuff as they go side by side. Gallo's got the inside line. Violette is on the outside. Just has to back out for a moment. Does Sophie Violette. Gallo holds firm in third.
Come on, Gallo, mate. It's of humanity. Never mind. There goes Violette up the inside there with supreme confidence. All Gallo can do is watch as the Sophie AI pulls away from in front. Speaking of the front, Rouge now has a 3.5 second lead over Igor Fraga and is extending. That's the battle for second right there. We can't even see Rouge anymore. Just see the rooster tails, the dirt being kicked up as it drives away in the distance. There is Igor Fraga in the bottom left-hand corner for speed, having to work very hard to keep Violette behind as they drift right in now. Look at the sideways all the way in, but no counter-steer. The car is just perfectly balanced on the throttle and brake. Looking up the inside now, Fraga covering it off just about, but I think it's going to be futile as Violette looks up the inside. Slides on by like Fraga is standing still.
Fraga then down into third place. Gallo's also dropped down, made a couple of mistakes behind Emily Jones, behind Sophie Blur and behind Sophie Ver. So Gallo from the podium positions just a lap or so ago, now down into 8th and last place in this race. Gap at the front has come down between Sophie Rouge and Sophie Violette, and this is going to be interesting as well, because of course we're talking about the AI versus real world driver battle, but I wonder what it's going to be like with an AI versus AI battle. Is Violette going to be able to get onto the back of Rouge? The gap now down to 2.7 seconds, so if we have a battle between those two, that'll get really exciting as Blur trying to have a half look there up the inside of Jones.
Yeah, well, this is a very unique experience as a commentator, as Emily Jones clouts the wall and then gets clouted by Blur AI versus humanity right here, ladies and gentlemen. It's awesome to watch the AI adapt, and Emily Jones doing a good job there in fifth place, keeping Blur and Ver behind as well. Gallo, though, down in eighth place. He's not having a good time. Our 2021 champer, unfortunately, not able to do much today. But onto the final lap now. Rouge leading from Violette, and Violette is actually gaining. 1.5 seconds now is the gap between the two leading AIs. Igor Fraga just about holding on to third from Tomioki Yamanaka, who's behind. Then behind them is Blur, Ver, and Gallo.
So then, on the final lap, we are Emily Jones sitting there in fifth place at the moment. The difference in lap times you can see on your screen, and you can see that Violette was quite significantly fast, about 1.2 seconds quicker than Sophie Rouge last time around. So two AI drivers battling amongst one another, and this is getting pretty spicy for the lead.
That best lap by Violette was 2.1 seconds
2.1,
faster.
Sorry, apologies.
Yeah, than any of the other drivers out there, the real drivers. That is insane. And these guys, you know, that's a lot of time for these guys. That's an absolute marathon for these guys in the GT World Series here. So meanwhile, it's Rouge versus Violette, and the gap's come right down now. It's 4 tenths, so AI versus AI for the last few corners.
This is going to get really exciting then. Violette versus Rouge. How is this going to work out then? So it's Sophie Rouge ahead of Violette as they come to the timing line. I think Rouge is just going to hold on. The checkered flag is out, and Sophie Rouge takes the win at Sardinia Windmills from Sophie Violette. Igor Fraga, the first of our GT World Series drivers, comes home on the podium ahead of Yamanaka, Emily Jones, Sophie Blur, Sophie Ver, and Valerio Gallo, completing the 8th driver strong grid.
I think the most obvious strength from Sophie is the consistency and also how precise they can do the input. It's not like human that sometimes we want to do the 50% on the brake, and sometimes, you know, it goes a little bit more, a little bit less, or, you know, stuff like that, and Sophie doesn't have it.
She recognizes your moves. Let's say if you defend the inside, she would attack you in the last moment when you don't expect it, because maybe I'm thinking she will not attack you. So it's like mind games. And also the defense, because she's gonna really defend you and break your slipstream. And actually, slipstream is another thing that it's really important to follow during the races. So she's reactive in this way.
Sophie に教わったことは、やっぱりこう早く走るためのその技術、例えばステアリングを切る操作、アクセルの踏み方、ブレーキの踏み方、すべてを教わりました。
I think there's already some stuff I've learned from watching Sophie today, like how much throttle and how much brake she's using. And it's interesting because she doesn't use like very much brake. It's only under 50%, which is I wasn't expecting.
Race 2 then for Race Together 2022 is about to get underway. Here are the drivers lined up on the grid here at the Lago Maggiore circuit. An Italian track, and fitting that the 2021 Nations Cup champion is on pole position with Sophie Rouge alongside him for company. Row 2, Igor Fraga, the Brazilian driver, and he has got Sophie Blur on the second row of the grid alongside Tomoaki Yamanaka, Japanese driver. Can he repeat his fortunes of race one with Sophie Ver alongside? Final row of the grid, Emily Jones in P7. And then Sophie Violette completing the 8 driver strong grid. Well, let's see what happens then as we get ready to go racing. Second race for Race Together 2022 at the Autodrome Lago Maggiore is underway as Gallo leads the field, and you can see the AI immediately darting into the slipstream. It's a 90 degree left hander for turn one. Are we going to see any moves being made into there? I think there might be a bit of a delay, and a dollar short. Sophie Rouge runs a bit wide. Igor Fraga sees as an opportunity, tries to go for the outside line. That turns into contact. Sophie Blur's on the inside. We're 4 wide on the exit of the corner here as Yamanaka goes and picks the pocket of them all and goes through into second place. Great driving from Tomoaki Yamanaka as he goes up from the outside the top five into second place, and now we're side by side with Sophie Blur on the curve and losing it round with contact there. Fraga collects Blur, and Blur is off and into the wall. So big drama on the opening lap.
Sophie there, not accustomed to how they race here in the GT World Series. That's great to see that action at the start there. And Yamanaka really making the best of all it, up to P2 there. Also, Emily Jones getting up to P5 from 7th on the grid. But you see already Sophie Roux sliding that AMD through and already right on the back of Yamanaka. Off they go to the wall. Was that contact? We just saw the end of that there. Severe in the wall as well. So far, a very poor showing for the Sophie AI. 6th, 7th and 8th and 3rd right now. Rouge is holding the baton for Sophie AI. As it looks around the outside of Yamanaka. Yamanaka is too clever to let that happen. And for now, stays in 3rd place.
Well, this has allowed Valerio Gallo to pull out an advantage of 1.7 seconds already at the end of this first lap. And Sophie Rouge really looking aggressive on the back of Tomoaki Yamanaka then as we come through into the final sector. Don't think that Rouge will be close enough to mount an attack on the Japanese driver as it stands for now, but if they can get a good exit out of the final corner, maybe that will allow an opportunity down in towards T1 here.
Really interesting to see the different lines that AI has taken compared to Yamanaka in front there, and getting the car almost sideways on purpose to turn the car, rotating the car on the slide into the last corner. That is insane. You will never see any of our guys trying that. So it just shows you the control that the Sophie Rouge has in that AMG. It's insane to watch, and even harder to try and get my brain around. Now, are they going to try and go for a move here on Yamanaka? Of course, the same is true for two people fighting, even AI and a person fighting. If you're fighting, you're slowing each other up. Fraga there in the background looking to try and make up some places after a poor start.
So then, the good thing is here for Igor Fraga that it's just going to allow him a little bit of an opportunity. He's going to see these two squabbling in front. If they start squabbling corner by corner, that will allow Fraga to just close up a little bit more than he's able to do. Rouge really late onto the brakes. Was there just the slightest touch into the back of Tomoaki Yamanaka? We're coming through into the middle sector. Yamanaka knows that, going for a bit of a defensive line as they flick it over into the left, goes back to the normal racing line as he is entitled to do. Don't think we're going to see Rouge making any moves at the moment through these corners because it's very much one at a time through here, but maybe he can try and force Yamanaka into a mistake. There's a long straight here. Rouge has got a good run out. Yamanaka knows that, tries to defend that position. Slipstream though is effective here for Sophie Rouge as they come down the hill in towards the right-hander. Who's going to break latest? Yamanaka's late on the brakes, but Rouge is trying to go round the outside as they come through the right-hander, and Yamanaka does hold firm for P2.
And they're going to make that one work around the outside there. The inside line really is away, but look at the different line through here. Yamanaka goes in wide. Rouge takes the grass on the inside, slides the car, and then is right back on the rear wing of Yamanaka in front, diving down the inside now. A little bit of contact there with Yamanaka, but Rouge up into second place there. But the door was open and Rouge went for it. That's a proper online manoeuvre if I've ever seen one.
Well, there's two laps left of this race. The question remains is, has now Rouge got the pace to try and close up the gap of 2.2 seconds to race leader Valerio Gallo? Clear air is really important, and you can see the AI there, the GT Sophie system, really maximising the track as much as they possibly can. Unfortunately for them, it is, as you said earlier on, Jimmy, just unfortunately Rouge that's carrying the baton for GT Sophie at the moment, because the rest of them are down the last three positions. Let's have another look at the replay then here. So you can see Rouge late on the brakes, a dive bomb down the inside. There was a gap there, entitled to do that. Yamanaka has to relinquish second place.
It makes me proud to see the AI dive bombing like a pro, like a prime. And you say the Rouge is holding the baton, but Violette is catching the back of the field now on the back of Emily Jones. And again, we really have to reiterate that these are all playing by the same physics set. I mean, it's very easy to make AI quick by just turning up the grip or turning up the power. They have exactly the same machinery, exactly the same controls as our human players, but of course they've had thousands of hours to learn the exact right way around. So basically in the head of the Sophie AIs, was that faster? Was that legal? Yes, okay, I'll do that again. And if it isn't, they give a sort of a virtual slap on the wrist and get told not to do it again. And through thousands of hours of learning, this is the result.
Yeah, it's an incredible machine learning system here. And you can see that is going to be put to effect here with Violette going towards the outside of Emily Jones as they go side by side down into the hairpin there. Jones knows that really cuts the nose off. A little bit aggressive there from Jones. I wonder if that's going to cost her a bit of time on the exit of the corner as Violette was just able to get the middle of that hairpin a little bit tidier through there. But Jones knows that Violette is going to come, and I don't know whether she is going to have anything in her pocket to be able to defend. This is where we saw Rouge going for a dive bomb move. Violette thinks better of it on this occasion.
Yeah, I mean, I think thankfully for Emily, I think the move is coming though, and it's going to be a lunge when we see it. At the front of the field as well, Gallo is being closed up on by Sophie Rouge behind, so we're going to have a fight for the lead in the last lap, I think, as well. But meanwhile, Jones and Violette still squabbling going into the last corner. You see Violette there, just trying sort of different ways to get the car loose almost, to help turn it. It's really interesting to watch what the AI is trying to do to rotate that car. So coming on to the final lap now, Emily Jones just about leading from Violette as we go into the first corner for the last time. Violette's just alongside the inside. No, oh, sideways there as they all try and get by. Here comes Sophie Blur in there as well now. So now Emily Jones has two of a Sophie AI to contend with.
That's the problem when it all concertinas up in those slower corners. You can see exactly what happens, and Violette does managed to eventually get ahead of Emily Jones, who now drops behind Sophie Blur to compound her woes there as well. The gap between the top two is now down to under a second for the first time since the start of this race, and it is Valerio Gallo, the man who is very much under pressure, and you can see there between the two of them that it's going to be really interesting when they come through this first sector to see what the sector times are between them, what the gap difference is, but visually we can see it is definitely coming down.
Yeah, I mean, this Valerio Gallo, just to remind you, is the 2021 Nations Cup champion. He is one of the fastest Gran Turismo drivers in the world, and right now through Sector 2, Sophie Rouge is 8 tenths faster and closing. We're into the last sector of the lap now. 6 tenths difference. Look on the brakes there. The absolute difference in ability to get the car slow down and turn there. And that is unreal, and Gallo really has to be careful now for these last few corners.
Yeah, he's really going to have to be watching his mirrors, as you say there, Jimmy, and coming through there, you can see the commitment of Sophie Rouge, but is an opportunity going to be presenting itself really over the curve as they close up on the brakes. They're running bumper to spoiler as they come through into the final series of corners, and if Sophie Rouge is going to do it, I think it might be a bit of a dive bomb up the inside through the last corner, because I don't know if a run to the line is going to be a possibility. Gallo knows that, goes for the defensive line, and Sophie Rouge tries to get the long way around the outside here at Lago Maggiore, and it's going to be a run then to the line, and I think Gallo is just about going to hold on. He does. Valerio Gallo wins here at Lago Maggiore in Race Together 2022, ahead of Sophie Rouge and Tomoaki Yamanaka on the podium. Gallo does a brilliant job there to get one over on the GT Sophie AI. What a result, what a drive.
GT Sophie has a great potential. I think the AI is already too quick, but still have to work on a little bit on, you know, like managing tire wear strategy and stuff like that. But once it's done like that, I mean, it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, Sophie とのレースっていうのは、その AI、あの、機械と戦ってるっていうよりも、まあ、人間と戦っているっていう感覚になっているので、あの、普段、あの、ライバルたちとレースをするのと同じ感覚でレースをしています。
I think our vision has always been to try to get Sophie to enhance the human experience. And by having an AI agent that can drive as well as the car does, we're trying to give an experience to people who want to improve their skill, who want to have more fun, ideally a combination of both. And that's what we're aiming for.